Dear students, so in yesterday's topic we have discussed about Coulomb's law and dielectric constant, or it is also called as relative permittivity. So relative permittivity is defined as the ratio of absolute permittivity in material medium to the absolute permittivity in free space is called as relative permittivity or dielectric constant. Right. Now, our next topic, that Coulomb's law is going to be expressed in vector form. So, this is also asked in March 2015, main exam. So, what write the Coulomb's law in vector form and explain the terms. There is a question, right? Now, see here, Coulomb's law we already know, right? So now I am going to consider. XYZ. So here, charge Q1, here charge Q2. So charge Q1 is, having the position vector R1, and Q2 is having the position vector R2. So simple. Now we consider one point another. On the XY plane consider one point. XY plane ಒಳಗೆ ನಾನು ಏನು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎರಡು ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು, ಒಂದು Q1 ಚಾರ್ಜ್, ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಏನು Q2 ಚಾರ್ಜ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ Q1 ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಏನಾಗಿದೆಪ್ಪ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಈ ನಮ್ದು ಏನ ಮಿಡಲ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ, ಈ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇಂದ, ರೈಟ್, ಈ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇಂದ ಅದರದ್ದು ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಏನ್ ತಗೊಂಡಿನಂದ್ರೆ ನಾನು ಆರ್ ಒನ್ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ತಗೊಂಡೇನೆ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಆರ್ ಒನ್ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ವೆಕ್ಟರ್, ರೈಟ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ this point Q2 is having position R2, so R2 is the position vector of Q2, R1 is position vector of Q1, right? Now see here, these two charges are point charges, so they are positive charges. So positive charges means we know already, plus there is a repulsion is there, minus there is also repulsion is there. So these two charges are now become positive charges, means they have to automatically repulsive each other. So repulsive each other means, see here, I am going to take F21. Why F21 here? See, this is the charge Q2, this is the charge Q1. When we are going to take near to the Q2, automatically force is on second charge due to first charge. Once again, I am going to repeat. See, force 2-1. 2-1 means force on second charge due to first charge. Right. Now, here, say, now this becomes F12. If I am going to take second charge nearer to the first charge, so there is another force, that force is force on first charge due to second charge, force on first charge due to second charge, right? Now see, another very important thing now. So here, force is a vector quantity. See, here, this becomes R12 position. R12 vector. So here, there is a direction like this. From Q1 to Q2. From R1 to R2. If I am going to take like this, this becomes R21. Here, 2-1. Here, 1-2. Very important thing. This one is very important thing. here 1 to 2 because force on second charge due to first charge. So then here our magnitude and direction becomes R1 to R2, R1 to. From here, which force on one due to second charge R2 to R1, R2 1. Right. Now see here, force exerted Q2 charge. Force exerted on Q2 charge due to Q1 charge. So we know already what we know. According to Coulomb's law. So when we are going to solve Coulomb's law in vector form, this is the very important thing, right? So we are going to consider xyz plane. In the xy plane, I am going to consider two point charges, two positive charges. So one charge is Q1, another charge is Q2. So Q1 charge is having R1 position vector. Q2 charge is from midpoint R2 position vector. Right? Here F21 is force on second charge due to first charge. Here F21 force on first charge due to second charge. So then what it becomes? Here the vector becomes R12 from R1 to R2. So here what happens? R21 from R2 to R1. R21 it becomes. Right. I am going to write here force exerted on Q2 charge due to Q1 charge. So then I am going to write F21. So we are going to put in the vector form. Force is a vector quantity. So then according to Coulomb's law, 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught, Q1, Q2 divided by F21 means, see, F21 here it is. What is our position vector? R12 square. Because we know F is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1, Q2 divided by R square. This is our Coulomb's law. So, here I am going to write R12 cap. Sir, why you are going to, sir, add further idiom. Why are you going to write R12 cap? R12 now showing the direction. R12 now showing the what? Direction. Very important. Why direction? Because Coulomb's law is now expressing in which form? Vector form. So write R12. Now I am going to write same thing. F. I am going to call equation number 1. Equation number 1 at the curriculum. Next, F12 is equal to same 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 R. R2 1 square. So then can I write R21? Yeah. I'm going to call equation number 2. F21 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 into R12 square. This is completely what? According to our Coulomb's law. Here, why I am going to write R12 cap? Here, our unit vector is denoting direction. So that's why I am going to write R12 cap. Here, F21, here it is. Right? Here, F12, R21, here it is. Right? After this one. Now see, another one thing. R12 is here. R21 is here. So can I write these are going to be equal and opposite direction? No, right? So then these are become what? Opposite. So then can I write R21 is equal. equal to minus R12. R21 is equal to minus R12. Sir, you minus yak bartri. Minus yak bartri nano. Opposite direction.
Opposite
direction.
Right.
I'm going to call equation number 3. Equation number 3. Right. Now, put this third equation in first equation. Right. F. Put 3 in 1. So now I am going to write F 21 is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. Now see, I am going to put this third equation in second equation. So what is our second equation? F 1 2 vector is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 divided by, so what is this, r12 square, so sorry, r21 square, r21 square. Right, now r21 is here, r21, can I write minus r12, minus r12. So see, here I am going to write, now it becomes F12 is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 divided by r21 square. R12, can I put minus sign here? So then this becomes F21 is equal to minus F12. F21 is equal to minus F12. See, here both forces are equal, but direction is opposite. But what? Direction is opposite. So then here what happens? The Coulomb's law obeys Newton's third law. Coulomb's law obeys Newton. F21 is equal to minus F12, or otherwise F12 is equal to minus F12, whatever you write. Right? Now see, extended vector form. How we are going to resolve extendedly? Right? Now see, we know already unit vector. What is our unit vector? I'm going to write R cap is equal to vector R modulus of R. This is our unit vector. This is our unit vector. Now see, here I am going to take R12 unit vector is equal to R12 vector R12 or modulus of R also, or modulus of R also. Now I am going to take, this is equation number 4. This is equation number 4. Now see, now I am going to take according to vector law of addition. See, R1 is having this direction, R12 is having this direction, and R2 is having this direction. This and this going in the same direction, clockwise direction, but R2 is going opposite in those two vectors. Now, I will write, see, R1, R1, here, this one means this direction. Plus R2. Sir, why you are, sir, we are plus R2, what is it? Plus R2, L2, one direction. So both are in the same direction. Now see, this R1 plus R12, this becomes what? Opposite to the, these two. So opposite means, I am going to write R2 is equal to 0. Is equal to 0. Now see, what I want now, R12, R12, here I am going to write, see, R2 is equal to, sorry, R12 is equal to, can I write, so
here I am going to leave here only. This takes here, it becomes plus R2. This takes here minus R1. So R12 is equal to R2 minus R1. I am going to call equation number 5.
Equation number 5. Now see, we know two equations. What are those?
So first I am going to write F21 is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by R12 square R12 cap.
R12 cap. So now, here see, I am going to write F or put for you in equation number 1. I think this is equation number 1. Right. See, F21 vector is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by. What is this? R12 square. So R12 square means, can I write this one? R12. So can I write R2 minus R1 square?
R2 minus R1 square.
So this becomes, so R12. Can I write
R2 minus
R1? R2 minus R1. It is cap. Cap means I am going to write R2. This is vector. This is like this. Or we can take also modulus.
Modulus.
Right. Now, F21 is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by R2. Already it is square. So, this square and this one, how much it becomes? R2 R1 cube. R2 minus R1 cube. Here, R2 minus R1. R2 minus R1. So, this is the part. Now, similarly, can I take R21 is equal to, so what it becomes, R21 cap, R21 cap, this is modulus of R, modulus of, here we can also put R21, right? So, I am going to call this one, sixth equation. Now, put 6 in second equation. Okay, second equation. So, what is our, we know already. What is that one? F12 is equal to Q 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 R21 square R21 cap. R21 cap. Here, F12 is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by. So, what is our R1? So, see, sorry, what is our R21? Now, see, here we want R21. See carefully here. From here to here, R2 like this. From here to here, Q2, here to the point to Q2, right? Original to Q2. This is R2. Now see, here, like this, this is R21. Now these two are, which direction? Clockwise direction. So then, can I write here, R2 plus R21. Now, R1 is coming like this means opposite direction, that is R1. So then, can I write minus R1? Why minus R1? Yeah, minus R1 baradilana? R1 equal to opposite baradilana. From vector law of addition. Vector law of addition. So then, is equal to 0. So now, I am going to write here C. I want R21. R21 is equal to R21 ile iruttini R1 ikkada tartini R2 ikkada tartini right so R1 minus R2. R1 minus R2. So, the minus is plus R2. Plus is the minus R2. R1 minus R2. So, now we got R21. So, now I am going to write here instead of R21, R1 minus R2 whole square. So, then here R21 means R1 minus R2 divided by R1 minus R2 modulus. So then automatically it becomes F12 is equal to F12 is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2. Again this becomes for Q R1 minus R2 whole cube R1 minus R2 vector. This is another one. So extended form of extended vector form of Coulomb's law. Extended form of Coulomb's law in vector form.
Charge is said to be 1 coulomb. So we define 1 coulomb only. 1 coulomb
if it attracts or repels, whatever it may be, attracts or repels the similar charge. Yes, the similar charge is there. So the similar charge, because we take similar charges here, q1 q2 is equal to 1 coulomb, both are similar charge, with a force of, how much it is the force? 9 newton raised to 9 newton. When placed, how much distance between the charges? 1 meter. 1 meter. So this is defined with 1 coulomb. So charge is said to be 1 coulomb if it attracts or repels the same charge with a force of 9 × 10⁹ when placed 1 meter apart. Right. So this is 1 coulomb definition. So in exams they are asking, what is the SI unit of charge? So then the answer is coulomb only. So when they are asking, define the SI unit of charge, means we are going to define the coulomb, not write the answer only coulomb. That is the wrong answer. We have to define what is the 1 coulomb. Define the SI unit of charge. Define what is the SI unit of charge? Coulomb. So then we are going to define. When we are going to write this definition, then only we are going to getting 1 mark. Otherwise, if we write the coulomb only, that is wrong answer. So now bare coulomb ant barra tappu. So now en baribeku, define 1 coulomb antaga complete definition baribeku. Charge is said to be 1 coulomb if it attracts or repels the similar charge with a force of 9 × 10⁹ when placed at 1 meter apart. Right. Now see, so small units of charge. Small units of charge. Now here 1 millicoulomb. 1 millicoulomb. So then can we write 10⁻³ coulomb? Milli means minus 3. Now 1 microcoulomb. 1 microcoulomb. So this becomes 10⁻⁶ coulomb. 10⁻⁶ coulomb. So then 1 nanocoulomb. Nanocoulomb. So it becomes 10⁻⁹ coulomb. 10⁻⁹ coulomb. So another one is that 1 picocoulomb. 1 picocoulomb. That is 10⁻⁻¹. 10⁻⁻¹. So these are the small units of charge. Small units of charge. So this is about unit of charge or 1 coulomb definition. 1 coulomb definition. So don't get confused when they are asking in suddenly. Yavagala musuru maadi ani answer bartat heli bariyottaga SI unit of charge geva coulomb barra correct. Define the SI unit of charge geva coulomb barra tappu. So neevu en maadbeku avaga 1 coulomb anna define maadbeku. Very important. Right? L select L. 16 select L and 16 select L. Same. Define SI unit of coulomb. So, 16 select L. What is the SI unit of charge? So, that is the only answer is coulomb.